A recent survey finds that wind turbines are killing not only local birds, but some that are migratory, coming from hundreds of miles away. News 18's Brad Oppenheim reports what that study found and whether wind turbines here at home pose a similar problem for birds.
Wind turbines are known to produce a clean form of energy, helping the environment. But in some cases, they've been known to hurt the environment.
Lots and lots of flying or volant animals are killed by wind turbines. That's just a fact.
In Northern California, the Altamont Pass Wind Resource Area is home to nearly 5,000 wind turbines. The wind farm is responsible for dozens of bird deaths annually, and researchers with the U.S. Geological Survey and Purdue want to find out where the birds are coming from.
Purdue is involved in trying to look at the genetics of these birds to figure out whether they are local birds that were born and hatched near the Altamont site, or whether they are birds from other parts of the country that are actually migratory.
Purdue Ag Professor Andrew DeWoody says the numbers are alarming.
It doesn't sound like 75 or 100 bird deaths may not be that many if we're talking about chickadees, but if we're talking about a long-lived species that lives to be 30 years old, has a 25-year breeding span, sort of on average, and we cut that short, it can have demographic consequences.
While there's a cause for concern on the West Coast, is there a problem here in Indiana?
Do we have that many killed in White and Bend County? No, we don't have nearly that many eagles. But it's certainly a cause of mortality, I'll put it that way.
Mike Kidwell is the vice president of operations at Auxilius Heavy Industries, which is a service provider for wind turbines in Benton County. He says he's never seen a problem locally with wind turbines killing any type of birds.
I myself have never found one. I've been here since 2008. So I helped do the construction on the Fowler Ridge Wind Farm, and I haven't seen any birds or any of those sort of things since then.
Although there may not be a concern in Indiana, DeWoody says he'd like to one day see a world where eagles weren't killed by any form of energy.
It's a constant struggle between humans and wildlife. You know, it just is, and it's going to continue to be for the foreseeable future.
Worldwide, DeWoody says wind turbines have killed hundreds of thousands of birds and more than 1 million bats. Brad Oppenheim, News 18.